Well, for the first installment of our four-part series, Korea's New Growth Engine, we look into Korea's development in IT sectors that use virtual reality, augmented reality, and artificial intelligence technologies. Now, those are currently part of the government's $2 billion project that will help raise the country's competitiveness in the so-called Fourth Industrial Revolution. First, here's our tech correspondent, Kim Ji-yeon.
A player finds his way to the location specified on his mobile screen and tries to capture the action figure to break the code. This will lead him to the next clue to solve a puzzle. The game, called The Code Chaser by local content developer Headplay, was inspired by the international best-selling novel The Da Vinci Code.
Instead of relying on pure chance for a Pokemon to pop on your screen, you have to make your way to the exact location and snap the right figure, sculpture, landmark, or signpost.
Code Chaser's story plot derives from a 2012 web cartoon and incorporates augmented reality technology, including GPS, or Global Positioning System, and MBS, or Multiple Virtual Storage, a technology that can determine whether or not the user captured on camera the right item at the right location. The company struggled to launch Code Chaser for the past 3 years because investors and state officials couldn't understand the need for an AR tech-based game. But it's a different story now that Pokemon Go has taken the world by storm. The company's co-founder says he expects the game to be in use starting next year in Chungcheongnam, the province, as a way to boost domestic and international tourism, education and commerce in the region.
The game's mission can be set up to capturing store signboards. When the game recognizes a registered establishment, useful facts and ads will pop up. We think the game can motivate users to visit a site by themselves, which is in a way the best way to promote. And we can even make it more interesting by changing the game's missions, routes, or stories once every month.
Another local gaming company, Mgame, hopes to become the country's leading gaming company by incorporating artificial intelligence into its virtual reality gaming version of its online game, The Princess Maker, in which players aim at raising a character into a princess. Through AI, the company hopes the game's princess successfully corresponds with its user through voice recognition functions.
Through AI, we hope the princess of the game gets to answer to the player by self-learning the context of words and phrases. It also needs to keep on learning human-like behavior and develop a personality of its own, as well as mimic the player's accents as well.
Mgame also hopes to hop on the AR and Pokemon Go bandwagon as well through the release of the Catchmon game later this month. The way the game is played is similar to Pokemon Go, but has additional data about popular cuisines and restaurants near any given location, as well as information of nearby players to promote coordination when facing a difficult move. To further boost the convergence of IT and content, the Ministry of Science, ICT and Future Planning unveiled plans to develop a flagship 3D platform in August for the development of higher-resolution VR device screens, as well as face and gesture recognition programs for interactive sets. This is expected to reduce Korea's technological gap with the U.S. in the virtual or augmented reality sector from 1.8 years to less than 6 months by 2020. Kim Ji-yeon, Arirang News.